One of the most important things you can do often in your soybean crop is to use a foliar fungicide. There are plant health benefits and also certainly for disease control. So today we're going to talk about your best choices and why you may consider spraying a fungicide in your soybeans.
All right, let's first talk about the disease protection. And to get good disease protection with any fungicide in any crop, you have to be out there in front of it. Fungicides are preventative products, and I realize a lot of the sales and marketing people will tell you, oh, this one has really good curative properties, but let's be honest here, the curative properties are for, hey, an infection is just beginning, maybe on 1 or 2% out there. Yeah, we can stop that. But if you've got an infection like on 50% of your leaf area, you're done. It's over. You've got to be out in front of that. So when we're anticipating when we're going to see disease, we have to look for when are the stressful times in our plant's life and when are diseases most commonly occurring in our area. Well, with soybeans, once they hit the reproductive stages of growth, that's where there's a lot of stress on those plants. There's a heavy nutrient demand. They're really working hard to produce seed. That's when you can get an infection, and right now is the time you have to protect yourself from disease.
Now, when we talk about getting the most out of your fungicide, Darren said you got to spray early, you got to be preventative, but the other big thing to understand is that fungicides don't move well in the plant. Basically, the leaf area that you touch, that's what's protected. If there are new leaves that come out, they're unprotected. And if you don't have good coverage in the beginning, well, you just didn't protect your plant hardly at all. So the important thing to understand is you've got to use a good amount of spray pressure, smaller spray droplets. It's whole different than if you're spraying, let's say, dicamba post-emerge. We want small droplets here, lots of water, and really great coverage.
Now, when it comes to specific diseases, we look at white mold as one where R1, or first flower out in the field, is the optimum time to start your treatment program, because that white mold fungus is going to get in through those dried up blooms. So as those blooms get pollinated and drop off, that's an open spot where the disease can get into the plant. So getting good coverage up and down the plant's important. Now the good thing too at R1, especially when we're in the northern part of the country, our soybeans aren't that big yet. So we can get pretty good coverage throughout the entire plant. When we get soybeans that are waist high or shoulder high, it's really tough to get down through that canopy very far. That's why I think this first application of fungicide is going to be important. Now, I mentioned the first application. For many of you, you may be saying, wait a second, I may not have used a fungicide before, or maybe I don't use one every year. Now you're telling me I have to use it more than once per season. Well, like Brian had said, fungicides don't move around in the plant much, so as we get new growth, we may need to protect that too.
All right, let's talk specifically about white mold. If you have a white mold issue or you're concerned about that, Endura is the best product. Unfortunately, it's $37 an acre, so you're not gonna wanna spray that everywhere. Only where you feel like you have a bad white mold issue. Then you're going to want to come back 2 to maybe 3 weeks later with something like Dalaro that's got some proline in there. Then follow up with Acropolis maybe 2 or 3 weeks after that. Acropolis has the active ingredients found in Topsin and Domark. So those are the best white mold fungicides. There's also the new Miravis Neo that you could try that we believe will have some decent white mold activity. The thing is, we'd like you to use multiple modes of action if at all possible. With Endura, that's an SDHI. With Proline, that's a triazole. Then you've got the other chemical family is the strobilurin family. That'd be like Headline, Quadris. Usually the strobes are not very good on white mold, but we like throwing it in there anyway for plant health. We'll talk more about plant health in just a minute. But before we do, usually with white mold, we're at R1. Also with SDS, where we want you to spray at R1. Fordix is the only product that's labeled for use at R1 to suppress sudden death syndrome. All right, if you just want to spray once and you say, look, all I'm after is just some general diseases and maybe this plant health, well, then we'd suggest spraying at R2, maybe just at the beginning of R3. So that would be full flower and very first pod.
So Brian mentioned plant health, and when we're talking this R2 to R3 application, that's what we're going for the most part. So when you think about that, the strobilurin family has been the go-to plant health products in the industry. We think about Headline and where it all started with, but there are a lot of strobilurin products. Now we've got the SDHI family as well, and we've seen some added plant health benefits from that too. So we're seeing more growers gravitating towards the 2 and 3 mode of action products, whether they're going for disease control and want to protect themselves from resistance, or they're going for plant health benefits and trying to get even a little longer lasting effect.
You've probably heard this plant health thing before and you said, ah, wait, plant health? What is that exactly? Well, specifically, there are three things. What we're seeing is less ethylene in the plants that have been sprayed with fungicide. What that means is that ethylene is kind of a stress hormone in the plant. It's going to make the plant finish earlier, or like Darren and I always used to talk about, premature death. Okay, if the plant lives a little longer and it lives healthier longer, usually we have more yield, so less ethylene there. The next thing is you're going to see more antioxidants in those plants. Finally, you're going to see cooler temperatures. Now that we have a lot of quick measuring tools where you can sense plant temperature, just sense that temperature where you've sprayed versus where you have not sprayed, and you will usually find that it's a little bit cooler in that canopy, which is a good thing in the heat of the summer, where you've sprayed a fungicide. So those are the reasons why we're seeing some yield gain out of the plant health benefits spraying in soybeans.
Specifically, some of our favorite products for plant health have been Preaxor, Trivapro, Stratego Yield, but there are many others out there too. The big thing is to spray a fungicide. We think it's a no-brainer in soybeans. We've seen good gains just year in and year out. A lot of growers are also using this timing to scout for insects and add an insecticide right in. You can certainly do that. Spray coverage is very important for insecticides too, so the same spray tips would be optimum for both of those types of products.
Darren was just mentioning spray coverage. Well, spray coverage is really important if you want to control our weed of the week. We'll tell you why coming up later in the show.